Thank you. Dear beloved, we've come together in the presence of God to witness joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The sacred relationship of marriage was established by God in creation. And our Lord Jesus Christ adorned marriage and his presence in the first miracle in Cana of Galilee. Apostle Paul chose marriage to symbolize the union between Christ and the church. And Holy Scripture commends marriage to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife and heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given to one another in prosperity and in adversity. When it is God's will for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but deliberately, soberly, and in reverent fear before God. Into this union, Gregory Bell and Shannon Sears now come to be joined. Gregory Bell, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, faithful unto her as long as you both shall live? Shannon Sears, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful unto him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Who's giving this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
The family and I do.
Our Lord Jesus Christ taught us that at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this cause, a man shall leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Consequently, they are no longer two, but they are one flesh. You've come to be made husband and wife. You'll join hands and repeat these vows after me. I, Gregory Bell, take you, Sharon Sears, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. As God is my witness, I give you my promise. I, Shannon Sears.
I, Shannon Sears.
Take you, Gregory Bell.
Take you, Gregory Bell.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Have and to hold.
Have and to
this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
The Word of God describes the kind of love we ought to have one for the other. It says that love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous, love does not brag, and it is not arrogant. It does not act unbecomingly. It does not seek its own. Love is not provoked, and it does not take into account a wrong suffering. It does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but it rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things. Love believes all things. Love hopes all things. And love endures all things. Love never fails. Having this love in your heart, you've chosen to seal your vows by the giving and receiving of rings. May I have the rings, please? Gracious and eternal God, Father, Lord, how we thank you now for this day. We thank you, God, for the gift of marriage. We seal these vows today by the giving and receiving of rings. I pray now, God, that you might bless this union and that you would sanctify these rings. May they always be a reminder to both Greg and Shannon, the love that they share this day, and the promise that they made to one another, and in your presence. We ask it in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Our Father. into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Now that Gregory and Shannon have given themselves to each other by solemn vows before us and before God as witness, have shown their affection and trust by the giving and receiving of rings and by the joining of hands, the power invested in me, the minister of the Lord Jesus Christ, by the state of Louisiana, I pronounce that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man ever separate. You may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Gregory Ford.
Started off sexy, what do you say? And all the ladies say. And all the ladies say. Think I like that. And all the ladies say. Welcome to the champagne life, where trouble is a bubble in a champagne glass. Dreams and reality are one and the same. And we gonna do it like this.
Got an addiction for life. Make this look easy. Sexy baby, don't you dare act
Yeah. days.
Wow.
Future past, they disappear.
So I don't hesitate, 'cause the worst things come.
kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain when it's pouring. Won't you give yourself to me? Give it all. I just wanna see. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, oh, you're the best part. Oh, you're the best part. Oh, best part.
Is this sunrise and those brown eyes? Yes, you're the one that I desire. When we wake up, love, it makes me feel so nice. You're my water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the Tylenol I take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine of my life. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. Know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, then you're the best part. If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you?
Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Bell. One of the key things that I want to advise you guys on, be supportive of each other, hold each other down, regardless of whatever the world put before y'all, do it together.
Congratulations, Shannon and Greg. One thing I want to tell you, to always keep God first. Put him in every decision you make, no matter what. Always put him first. And I want to wish you all the best. And it's going to be some rough times. I'm not going to tell you that it's not. I've been married 36 years, and I wouldn't want to be nowhere else but where I am now. And I'm going to be there, like they said, to death do you part, and I plan on doing it. Might be his now, but it'll be all right.
All right, congratulations, Shannon and Greg. Shannon, you know, I'm your big brother-in-law, slash brother. And one thing I can say, just keep God in your marriage, keep your family out your business. Everything that can go between you and your husband, your household. Keep your family out your household and God in it. And everything will be all right. Love both of y'all.
Good afternoon, friends and family. I want to congratulate Mr. and Ms. Bell on a successful wedding. The road to success consists of a lot of up and downs and what you learn from those lessons. Keep God first in your life. Remember the conversations that you and my wife have had on a number of nights. If you hold that and hold on to each other, don't worry about anything else. The two of you will be just fine.
Greg and Shannon, know that Dwayne and I love you oh so very much. We encourage both of you to never give up on each other, never let go of that third strand in your marriage, which is God, and always, always, always love each other and communicate. Greg, like I told you the first day I met you on the campus of Arkansas Baptist College, as long as you do right, we always have your back. And Shannon, that now goes for you too. We love you both and we wish you many, many years of love.
Loving me and changing me and saving me. See, I was lost. I was lonely, but you came in.